is. Piet Mondrian sent a message that he was in Holland and that he could not return to Paris. Mrs. Hannert invited him to stay. And when, one afternoon, I arrived, he was sitting with her at table. He made a curious impression upon me because of his hesitating way of speaking and the nervous motions of his mouth. During the summer of 1915, he stayed in Laren and rented a small atelier in the Nulse Street. In the evenings, we would go to Hamdorf because Beat loved dancing. Whenever he made a date, preferably with a very young girl, he was noticeably good-humored. He danced with a straight back, looking upwards, as he made his stylized dance steps. The artists in Laren soon began to call him the Dancing Madonna. In 29, I was with him one afternoon in Paris and met the Hoyaks in his atelier. After a while, without saying anything, he put on a small gramophone, which stood as a black spot on a small white table under a painting of which it seemed to be the extension, and began quietly and stiffly with Madame Hoyak to step around the atelier. I invited him to dine with me as we used to do in the old days. Walking on the boulevard Aspai, suddenly I had the feeling that he had shrunk. It was a strange sensation. In the metro, we said goodbye. When we heard the whistle, he placed his hand on my arm and embraced me. I saw him slowly walking to the exit, his head slightly to one side, lost in himself, solitary and alone. That was our last meeting.